Are you ready for drama? Are you ready for excitement? Are you ready for nerve-wracking moments? We're in KwaZulu-Natal to find out which of our school teams will be crowned our unsinkable outdoor class. Who will protect the honor of their school? Who will sink? And who will swim? Elami Kama Usama Ngesi, and this is Challenge SOS. In the second challenge of our first elimination round, we saw Team Umhlaba from Clearwood Secondary and Team Amamzi from Rossborough High battling it out in our rope adventure at uShaka Marine World. Let's take a look at how the challenge went down. There we go, there we go. So they're coming through, making the funky noises. So much teamwork going on here. The last team left, and Leon is making his way down. So much love, so much teamwork. Vandag is ons hier by uShaka Strand in Durban, waar ons spanne sal spiere moet inspan om ons skole se trots te verdedig. This is the third challenge of four in our first elimination round. And once all four challenges have been completed, the winning team will go through to that big semi-final. Hey guys!
Hey.
How you guys doing? Are you guys good?
Yes.
Are you guys ready for today?
Yes!
Who will be our unsinkable outdoor class of this year? Team Amamzi?
Yes.
Or Team Umhlaba?
My name's Dominique, I'm 16 years old. I go to Clearwood Secondary School and I'm in grade 9.
My name is Marlon Feldman, I'm 16 years old. I go to Clearwood Secondary and I'm in grade 10.
My name is Michaela, I am 14 years old. I go to Clearwood Secondary High School and I'm in grade 9.
I'm going to go to Clearwood High. I'm going to go to Clearwood High. I'm 16 years old.
Kamala Munyakalo, Wagorchasi, Gina 15 years old, in Gifunda Rosbeck High School.
Kamala Mi Sandisiwe, Boagandaba, Ginimyaga 13, Gifunda Grade 8, Rosborough High School.
Kamala Mi Nguenzile, Ginimyaga 14, Gifunda Rosborough High School, Genza Ibanga 8.
My name is Chile Leon Ristoff, I'm 16, I go to Rosborough High School.
So last week's chimpanzee course was so fun and I can't wait to do today's kayaking. I've never done it before, so it'll be pretty awesome.
I'm going to go to the Umhlaba so kwenza kahle ngoba na last week khona besizamile ukwenza kahle kodwa ngibona ukuthi namhlanje so fake effort eningi kunalo last time.
We got a good chance of winning today. I've paddled before, so I'm going to tell my team what I've experienced and give them some good tips on how to kayak.
Because I haven't kayaked before, it's pretty nerve-wracking and exciting at the same time. I'm scared because of the waves. I don't want the kayak to flip over and maybe I'll drown or something scary like that.
Namhlanje ngizizwa ngijabulile ngoba le challenge sinikezwe yona ngikaze ngayenza esikhathini esedlule futhi ngingajabula ukuthi ngiyenze. Ngithola ulwazi ukuthi yenziwa kanjani nokubona ukuthi sizophumelela nje.
The challenge that I'm going to be doing today, I've did it before, like just for fun when you come visit uShaka. Just do it for fun, so I'm not really scared.
Le enye team Umhlaba nabo ngibone ngathi bazowenza kahle ngoba nabo futhi banomuntu oyedwa oseke wa kayaka before, so angazi okwamanje nje. Neck and neck, a gazoo, good six zones at a land.
Omitting Lapa, Imanzini, things are Ukamba, Nindu, and we push into Imanzini. I think that will help a lot because I'm tall and strong. I guess that is a great combination.
Tabiso is the strongest member because just by looking at him, you can see that he's pulled up, he got big hands, and that he can help us in some of the challenges, but we know we can also be the strongest in other challenges that may be coming up for us.
Futhi ngibona ngathi soyiwina le challenge ngoba igama le-team lethu amanzi futhi challenge yanamhlanje izobe isemanzini, so lokho kuzosenza ukuthi siphumelele even more ngoba amanzi namanzi ahlangene.
I think digging under the log would definitely drain us of energy. because like we'll be digging a big hole because Leon is very big compared to all of us. So I think we'll be pretty tired by the time we have to kayak around the buoy. But I'm not afraid of getting my hair dirty or my nails dirty. That's okay with me.
Today's challenge is a head-to-head ocean kayaking relay race. One member from each team will race at a time. When the race starts, each team will have to dig a hole and a stationary log on the beach. Once they have dug the hole, one team member must crawl under the log, run to the water, and start kayaking. Each member must kayak around a buoy in the ocean and then head back. Once back on the sand, they'll have to crawl under the log again, tag the next team member who will then have to crawl underneath the log before kayaking out to sea. If any team member lifts the log, they'll have to take a penalty and wait 30 seconds on the beach before they can start kayaking. The first team with all four members back on the beach wins.
Who will sink? Who will swim? Who will be crowned our unsinkable outdoor class? Find out here on
Challenge SOS!
Sawubona buthi. Alright teams, nayi instructor yenu ubhuti bangani. Buti, iredi ikayak yethu?
Ya, seyiredi. Ke sine life jacket la. Ke uzogqoka ngathi ugqoka ijacket. Ke then sine page yakho. Ke chuti uzogibela ku kayak yakho. Ke chuti mawufuna ukujika. Ke mawufuna ujikela ngaku right. Ugwedla ngaku left. Uzojikela ngaku right. Mawufuna ujika ngaku left. Ugwedla ngaku right. Uzojikela ngaku left. Mawufuna uyaphakathi ushaya left and right. Keep your kayak. Straight kayak yakho. Then it's Amamzi. Have a nice trip, guys.
All right. Do you guys have any questions? Siyabonga buti. Ngabalinda lapha Amamzi. All right, teams, have you guys decided on the order that you guys will be going in?
Yes!
Are you guys ready?
Yes!
All right, you guys can take up your positions and let's start the race. All right, teams, are you ready?
Yes!
Remember that your school's honor is on the line. So try your best. And now it's time for us to find out who will sink or swim! Yeah. Right, Team Umhlaba seems to be digging really hard.
But I don't really know what Marlon is doing right there at the back. They need to make a hole that goes under the log.
I enjoyed digging a hole for our team to go under, although it was quite hard at first points, but eventually we got to it and we made progress.
Jordan is encouraging his team. The competition is neck and neck at the moment. Both teams have cut through to the other side. Are their holes big enough for their teams to get through?
Leon's very pussy, and then today when we like approached him about his attitude, he's like, I'm short-tempered. So we like, don't take your short-temper down us. Just we here as a team, we're gonna work as a team. So if you're gonna have attitude, we're gonna have attitude towards you. And if you don't like it, then don't give it to us. We spoke to Leon and we told him that he better buckle up and stop having that attitude all about himself, because he's not here by himself. We're all working as a team and we're all gonna win together.
Both teams are digging viciously. It's neck and neck at the moment. It's hard to say which team will dig their way into the lead. The teams need to remember to dig their holes big enough so that each team member can get through without lifting the log. If they lift the log, it is a 30-second penalty where they have to wait on the beach before they can get into the water. This is very crucial, as this could be the difference between winning and losing. Both teams have dug their way through to the other side. They're about to get into their kayaks.
I was the first to go in, and when I was putting on my life jacket, it was quite a little bit hard because I forgot to put on the zip, but I eventually found the zip.
When I got into the water, I jumped onto my boat, and then when I started paddling, I could feel that the waves were pushing me back, and I just paddled harder and harder until I could get out there.
When I got into the kayak and started paddling, it was quite difficult because the waves were just coming, and trying to paddle at a certain speed was quite hard, because most of the time I was going off course or maybe just doing something, but eventually I found out and I figured it out.
Team Amamzi's Jordan is in the lead. He's about to go around the buoy. And he makes it. He's on his way back right now. Marlon is struggling to keep up. Our two teams making sure their holes are big enough for the bigger members of their team. Jordan from Team Amamzi is back on the beach, pulling his kayak towards his team.
I had to go after Marlon. So when he came and tapped my hand, I had to go really fast under the pole. But at the same time, I had to go very slow so I wouldn't get the penalty.
Both teams currently sending their second members, Michaela for Team Umhlaba. Michaela's already by the kayak, putting on her life jacket. Wenzile is struggling to get through that hole.
Ngizamile ukudlula kodwa ngayithinta ilock okwenza ukuthi sime u 30 seconds before ngiqhubeke ngihambe.
Team Amamzi gets a first penalty of 30 seconds. 30 seconds starting now. Four, three, two, one, go! Wenzile is now getting ready to get on her way. Michaela's already in the water for Team Umhlaba. She's getting into her kayak. She's gonna start paddling.
I had to go in the boat. I went the wrong way. I didn't get in the boat at the right direction. So I had to get out the boat, turn it around, and then get back in, which took some time.
Wenzile of Team Amamzi is a bit behind at the moment. Will she be able to catch up?
Ngenkathi uwenzile ethola ipenalty ya 30 seconds, ngivetane ngabona ukuthi hayi ngeke ngoba ngiyazi ukuthi into ebengakaze ayenze. So ngenkathi futhi semanzini ngambona ukuthi uyahluleka kancane. So nami emqondweni yami bese ngicabanga ukuthi hayi kuzomele ngisheshe nami ngizame ukusheshe.
Wenzile is struggling a little bit, gets a little bit of a push from Smoo to send her in the right direction, and she turns the wrong way again. Michaela is taking it back to the beach, pulling her kayak back towards her team. Michaela back under the log. Dominique goes through. Team Umhlaba has made a big enough hole for the teams to just get through seamlessly. Wenzile is still struggling on that water. Dominique now putting on her life jacket and getting ready to go through into the water.
I think when I was running backwards, I kind of tripped over because I was rushing into the water. But then I just got up and I carried on going.
Dominique has fallen with her kayak, but she makes her way up again and runs towards the ocean.
At first, Dominique, when she went through the hole, she made it perfectly. But then when she took her life jacket and put it on, and when she was struggling to pull a kayak and she fell back, which we knew it was okay. She'll get up on her feet quick. And while she got up, we encouraged her, and we could see that she was focused on the competition. She wasn't even worried that she fell. She just focused on going and winning the competition for us.
Wednesday, make your way back to the beach as well.
Ngiyazethemba futhi ngiyayithemba i-team yami ukuthi senze kahle soloko saqala ngoba siqale kahle namhlanje kwangahamba kahle kakhulu kodwa lisakhona ithuba lokuthi senze kahle.
Wenzile makes it underneath the log. Wenzile tags in uSandisiwe. Sandisiwe slowly trying to get under that log, trying to make sure that she doesn't lift the log. Could mean a 30-second penalty for them.
Ngenkathi ngihamba mina ngibonele enye team sengathi biphambili, so nami ngazama ukuthi ngisheshe kancane kodwa ngaba nenkinga ngifasa uziphwe life jacket yami, so kodwa ngicabanga ukuthi ngenze kahle kakhulu.
Dominique is doing really well on the paddling. It's clear that she listened to those instructions that were given by Bongani. Things are getting heavy here on uShaka Beach. So let's take a quick breather, but don't go anywhere because the race isn't finished yet. Team Umhlaba and Team Amamzi are currently taking part in our ocean kayaking and beach relay race. And it looks like it's going to be an intense finish. Dominique making her way back to the beach.
When we made all those mistakes, it was very hard for us to really think that the team will catch up because they were still battling. But we weren't really focused on them. We were just focused on our team and how we're going to make it through.
Dominique makes it through under the log easily. Leon, touch the log. Need to wait for 30 seconds.
Angzang cutting toilet at the second and 30-second penalty. Angizange ngijabule kahle ngoba ngifike ngabona ngathi lento izosimisa uthi siwini.
When Leon had that, when got the 30-second penalty, I was okay. That gives us time to relax, not to rush things. Because I saw the other team, they were still behind. And I thought to myself, Leon, just do it for fun. Don't rush into it.
And in 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, go! Leon racing towards the water. That is the last team member for Team Umhlaba. Team Amamzi is still on their third team member. They still need to get her under the log and send their next one out. Nyakalo is the last team member for Team Amamzi.
Eh bese ngitatazela kakhulu ukufaka life jacket yami ngoba bese ngibona laba le enye team ibisiqeda futhi benginokutatazela khona nokusaba.
Leon is already going around the buoy for his team. He only has to make his way back to the beach and under the log and they will have won this challenge. Team Umhlaba encouraging their last member, Leon. He's making his way back to the beach, but he's struggling to get that kayak onto some dry land. Leon has taken off everything that he needs to. All he needs to do is get under the hull. Woo! Confidently dives underneath it. Team Umhlaba makes it back.
Mina ihambe kabi kakhulu ngoba sikhathi sengene emanzini le enye i-team yona ibisisiqeda and ngabona ukuthi besingekho vele into bengasiza ngayo i-team yami kodwa nje njengokuqhubeka njenge-team member banginikeze the support labanginikeze yona.
Both teams cheering on Yakaro to come back to the beach. There he is. players running back to the beach.
Ngisho noma ngibonile ukuthi i-team umhlaba wona obusuqedile kodwa ngizamile nje ukuqeda i-race ngenzela ukuthi i-team yami ingabisiphoxeka ngami ibone ukuthi angiqedanga nanani njenga izinto enjalo.
Bending his back to try and get under that log. Team Amamzi back.
Kule challenge namhlanje njengoba singaphumelelanga. Angijabulile ngaleyo ndlela kodwa ngijabulele le enye team futhi ngibona ngathi sonke senze kahle.
Today's challenge is absolutely awesome because we beat Team Amamzi. I can't believe we won because we had never kayaked before and listening to the instructor really did help us and building the hole very big really did help us as well.
Ukuthi siluzile challenge namhlanje lokho akuchazi lutho ngoba asiwazi ama scores akwama challenge lawa sesiwenzile futhi na next week siyazi ukuthi sizowenza kahle futhi sizolethi a game yethu.
Both teams have worked hard to complete the challenge but Team Umhlaba has come out victorious. Now Dominique, tell us, how do you feel after the race?
I feel exhausted, tired. My heart was most beating when I fell when I was running in the water with my kayak. But then I felt I remembered my school and my team. I jumped back in my kayak and I carried on going.
All right, Team Amamzi, unfortunately you guys didn't win today, but you guys did work hard. Wenzile, tell me, what could you guys have done better to win this challenge?
I think that my team and I could have dug deeper and ran as fast as possible.
All right, our two teams still have one more challenge to go in this elimination round, and as much as Team Umhlaba may have won today's challenge, we still do not know the results from our first two challenges. At the moment, it is anybody's game. Voel jullie positief?
Yes!
Wie gaan jullie schoolse naam hoog hou? Onthou om ons Facebook-blad te volg voor al die extra pret hier op Challenge SOS. And remember to tell all your friends about the nice kayaking challenges that you saw on Challenge SOS today, and maybe you guys can try them out together. But right now, let's go for a sneak preview of our next episode where our two teams take on a horse riding challenge.
Let's go, Leon. Go fetch the ball, Leon.
Aim.
Gets it in! Join us again next week to find out which of these two teams will be the first one to go through to our epic semi-final. And remember, life's a challenge. Only you can decide if you sink or
swim!